spoken in this film are excerpts from the writings of EDVARD MUNCH. On the whole, art is the expression of man's need to communicate. All ways are equally good. Too often in painting, as well as in literature, the means are mistaken for the end. Nature itself is not anything but a means. A work of art comes only from man's inner self. It is the human being, the life that one shall try to express, not dead nature. Nature is not only what is visible to the eye, it is also the inner pictures of the soul, pictures on the other side of the eye. It sometimes happened that in a morbidly excited mood, or one of happiness, I would find a landscape I wanted to paint, and I painted the picture from nature. But I did not manage to paint it in a morbid or happy mood that I had experienced. This often happened. So I began to scratch out what I had painted. In my memory, I tried to find the first impression and tried to get it back. I do not believe in an art which does not come from man's need to open his heart. Art is one's heart blood. In my art, I have tried to explain for myself life and its meaning. I have also attempted through my art to help other people to understand life. My first impression when I saw the sick child was of a pale head with bright red hair against a white pillow, a quivering mouth, trembling hands. This first impression faded as I worked on the picture, and I painted again and again to recapture. In the painting of the sick child, I explored new paths. Most of what I later carried out in my art had its birth in the first completed version of this picture. Chair where the sick child sat as I painted her, all my beloved ones used to sit, winter after winter, longing for the sun, until death took them away. The painting called Spring is meant to be a contrast between the germination of the spring and the sun outside and the dying spring inside. Spring portrays the deathly sick girls longing for sun and warmth, for life. In the painting Sick Child and Spring, there is no question of outside influences. The influences are those of death and sickness in my childhood home. Around midsummer time, when the air is soft and warm, when it is light all night, how soft are all the lines and colors. How light the colors are shining against the deep blue sky. And yet in this moment lie thousands of people twisting in death agony. As a child, I suffered from poor health. My mother died when I was 5 years old, and my sister when I was 14. But when I paint sickness and suffering, I feel it is a healthy reaction to this, from which one can learn and live. I have been working on a series of paintings called The Life Frees. Decorative pictures, which, taken all together, will provide a picture of life. Through the frieze runs the curving shoreline. Beyond lies the ocean, always in movement, and beneath the crowns of the trees, life is lived in all its variety, with all its joys and sorrows. My paintings are moods, impressions of the spiritual life that together create a picture of the struggle between man and woman, which is called love. I would present a series of such pictures. No longer shall interiors be painted depicting people reading and women knitting. I will paint living beings who breathe and feel, suffer and love. A poem on life, love, and death. gives herself for love and attains a Madonna's hurtful beauty. We are born of a woman. What is more remarkable than this? Is not this thing the most remarkable? Simplification in my art. The fear of life has accompanied me ever since I can remember. Yet I have the feeling that the fear of life is a necessity to me, just like illness. Without the fear of life, I should have been like a rudderless ship. One evening I walked down a road. On one side, the fjord spread out below me. I was tired and ill. I stood there looking across the fjord. The sun went down. The clouds were colored red like blood. I felt something like a cry pass through nature. I thought I heard a cry. I painted this picture. I painted the clouds like real blood. The colors cried out. This was to become the picture of the shriek and the life freeze. Produces one's own mood, and it is this mood which is the essential. Woman in three stages. The dreamy woman, the happy earthy woman. The woman is a nun with her pale head gazing between the tree trunks, the voluptuous white body against the somber colors of sorrow. Life on earth, of the eternal torment in hell that awaited the children of sin. I felt that I was unfairly treated, motherless, sick, and with the menace of infernal punishment hanging over my head. There are some forces which always connect my home with illness and death. Certainly, I can never overcome these disasters. They have been decisive for my art. I painted the picture melancholy. I had the melancholic sit by the flame-red table. It was important to make her large, powerful, and monumental in her dark, mute grief. As well as of death, of the forest that draws its nourishment from the dead, and of the town growing up behind the treetops. It is a picture that shows the strength and the bearing forces of life. Thank you. personal fears of being pursued became more and more overpowering to me. And I went into the clinic in Copenhagen in 1908. Jacobson was an efficient doctor. Everything was white at the clinic, except Jacobson. I painted him big and dominant, in a fire of all hell's colors. Century, I felt a need to break up the surface and the line. I felt that my earlier way of painting could easily become mannered. Life. Summer days with late sun. Sun that falls in through the window. And was physically healthy and painted one of my best paintings, the bathing picture. My paintings need some sun and dirt and rain. Some have been hanging in the outdoor studio exposed to wind, rain, and snow. Rough treatment does not hurt them. Then the colors are more harmonious, for the surface appearances are hard and brutal when they are new. Thank you. group of three people is always uncomfortable. Only two of them can speak together. The third only waits to break in. I have always worked best with my paintings around me. I placed them together and felt that each painting had a relationship with the other paintings, both in content and in form. When they were placed together, a feeling of harmonious sound went through them. They were completely different. It was like a symphony. I believe that a series of related paintings may well have the same effect as a symphony. It can reach an intensity in the light and recede into the depths. It can rise and fall in strength. In the same way, its tones can ring out and re-echo with the occasional strident notes and the tones of drums. Nevertheless, there may be rhythm. made a sketch of this personal incident perhaps 20 years ago. Now I have painted it. But it only looks like a summer night's landscape with a man who points a gun. People do not understand that one paints to experiment and to develop oneself in order to reach the heights. I need to absorb myself in my art and to work in peace. I have always been faithful to the goddess of art. Therefore, she has never left me. What I have to give are my paintings. Without them, I am nothing. My art has been a confession.